ladies and gentlemen, the amazing Kreskin.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much. Appreciate it. Well, we have a rather small audience tonight, which is unorthodox for this kind of program. They're an exciting audience. I can get good vibrations. I only assume that somewhere in downtown city nearby here, probably a UFO landed, and they're expecting the old Kreskin to come out, who was Houdini, they tell me sometimes. I don't know. But it's good to have you here. And listen, folks, it finally happened. All the years that I was kidding about it, thank goodness somebody was with me as a witness. But on April 13th of this year, I was formally and officially banned, not from performing, thank God, but from ever attending any gaming table somewhere in Las Vegas, Nevada. It has been in 74 newspapers throughout the world, and I'll tell you more about it after the following commercial break. Stay tuned, folks. This is the phase of my program that has become almost a signature in my lifestyle. And from time to time through the years, folks, I've had some dramatic results. I just did a program with former President Ford, actually when I was in Las Vegas. And we had a small audience, but an unbelievably receptive group of people. Maybe the chemistry, because of you people being so close, causes a good interaction. Now, I want you to concentrate. If I say something that rings a bell in your mind, stand up immediately. It may not even be what you're thinking of as you're thinking now, and I'm trying to prime you to concentrate. It may be on a secondary level, what we call a semi-conscious level. Let me ask you folks here in the audience, his or her thoughts on... Say, I want to say honey. This is exactly what happens if my reasoning confuses me, but as I thought about it, you're correcting me wherever you are. You're thinking H-O-N-G. Well, Hong Kong. Who's thinking Hong Kong? Please stand. Gal right back there who has that wonderful wide-eyed expression. Listen, have you been there, ma'am?
No.
Are you thinking of going there?
No.
Well, who was there?
My brother.
How long ago was it, ma'am?
He's still there.
Is he working there?
Yes.
Let me ask you this. Does this have to do with anything dealing with antiques or something of a value?
No.
What kind of work is he in, ma'am?
Chartered accountant.
What kind?
Chartered accountant.
Charging accounting.
Chartered accountant.
Oh, chartered accounting. Thank you very much for standing. I just couldn't zero in. Who's concentrating? See, it's interesting how suggestion works. She thought of another part of the world, and suddenly somebody here in the audience is thinking of Scotland. Where are you here in the house? Would you stand? Same gal. She's going to get a coronary if I don't get through with her. Have you been to Scotland?
Yes.
How long ago, ma'am?
6 years. That's where I'm from.
Now, you were born in Scotland. In Edinburgh? Thank you very much for standing, ma'am. I really appreciate it. You know, we tape shows. Some of the shows you see were taped in Newcastle, England, which is not too far from the border of Scotland. I must appear in Scotland. Our show is seen there. Who in the audience is concentrating his or her thoughts? I get the name Kevin. Not the... Ma'am, obviously I could work with you all day. This is, we have never met before, have we?
No.
You seem relieved of that fact. Let me ask you, is Kevin your child?
Yes.
You're asking me, and I'm going to then try to zero in on someone else because I don't want anyone to think that I use any Confederates. And as you said before, we do not know each other. We've never met before. You've been asking me if I can give you his birth date. Am I correct? You're
yes.
Stunned. One digit of the day?
Yes.
His birthday fall on March the 6th?
Yes.
Thank you very, very much for standing, ma'am. Thank you. Someone here in the audience is thinking the name... Carol, where are you here? Oh, not ma'am, I'm going to have you remain seated. Is that another daughter?
Yes.
A child? You know, ma'am, your mind is so clear to me. By the way, let me ask you, does April have any significance to you?
Yes.
What is it, her birth date?
Yes.
I'm going to ask you to stop thinking. This is a dramatic thing because it's one of the few times it's happened, but I could work with you. Ma'am, if you lift your head up, was she Born on April the 22nd?
Yes.
Thank you very, very much, ma'am. I very much appreciate it. I have got to get away from that gal. My gosh. Now, you know, I could have passed from her immediately so that no viewer would think anything was prearranged or rigged or so forth. But it's more natural, the fact that her thoughts kept coming in stronger and stronger to me. And I could have worked with you all evening mentally, I want you to know. Now you're reading my thoughts out there in the house. Who in the audience, if it's the gal there that I'm zeroing in, I'm going to ask her not to stand. But who is thinking, see, we're getting back to the Aaron. I get the name Aaron. The gentleman right there. Who is Aaron, please, sir?
My new baby daughter.
You new baby daughter. Well, yes. Congratulations. How many? You say new one. Do you have two children? One is older.
Yeah.
Two girls?
She is the third. I have
she's
two daughters.
She's the third. Who is Lee, may I ask you, please, sir?
That's my wife.
Sure. Is she here with you?
No, she's not.
All right. In your mind, you've had what you consider, well, I wrote down a goal or an aim of some kind. Am I correct?
That is.
Yes. Well, does it have to? You're stunned. Would she know what you had in mind, yes or no? You've discussed it before you came here. Do you know what the goal is, ma'am? Would you stand up? I've never met you, have I?
No.
And just say yes or no. Does it deal with me?
Yes, it does.
To meet me?
Yes.
That will let you. Well, listen, let me. The gentleman, I can't deal with it. It's a pleasure to see you, ma'am. Ooh, that made my day, I'll tell you. God. I'm going to ask you to stand. Let me ask you, if you will stand a moment, please, either of you. The gal right there. Is there something coming up maybe this year that has some significance to you in the future, yes or no? To you, sir, is there anything specific? Not particularly. All right, then I may not be. A change of job, potentially?
No.
No, oh, good. Well, I mean, I don't want you to have to change a job. I don't want you to think that way. No, no. Who is concentrating on... By the way, that kiss just made my evening. The show can go any direction. Who's thinking the name Walter? Would you kindly stand, please? Something about someone's health. Ma'am, who is Walter?
My son-in-law.
Are you concerned about his health, ma'am,
yes,
in some
very.
Way? He's not in the hospital now, is
no.
he, ma'am? Has he been?
No.
But he has seen two physicians, am I correct?
Yes.
And you were not thinking of that fact at this moment,
no,
were you?
I wasn't.
Let me ask you this, ma'am. There's no problem with... is part of the problem dealing with migraines or headache pains that reflect it?
Yes.
It is.
Yeah.
I'm not here to give a diagnosis. Is he in this area here, ma'am? In this
no.
state?
Yes.
In this country?
Yes.
Yeah. Who's in... By the way, why were you thinking of Spain?
Because I'm going there.
You're going to Spain. And who is Dorothy?
My daughter.
Thank you very much for standing, ma'am. I really appreciate it. Thank you. Oh, I can. What? Something very, very quickly, because I'm not aware of time cues, but everything's going so well that we're going to continue. Who here in the audience? I cannot get the impression clearly. It seems like some. Does Chara ring a bell, please, to anyone here in the house? Would you kindly stand? The name Chara?
Chara.
Yeah. Chara. How do you spell that? The way I would think of it, sir?
T-A-R-E.
Is that your daughter or
That's
what,
my
sir?
My daughter, yeah.
You have two children?
I do.
Are either of them here with you?
No.
They're home?
They're home.
That's not here, though, yes or
not
no?
Not here, not here.
I cannot get... There's one other child. I cannot get... Is it a boy?
A boy.
I cannot get the name. I see Dave, but it doesn't seem right. How do you spell his name?
D-E-V.
D-E-V.
That's right.
See, my reasoning forced me to put the E after the V. How do you pronounce it? Dev?
Dev.
By the way, you have to return home shortly, don't you? Yes
That's
or no?
Right.
You've been thinking about that.
That's right.
Are you from the United Kingdom?
I am.
Thank you very, very much for standing. Thank you, folks. And we will certainly be back, that I foresee, after the following message. Thank you. Our special guest has been seen in television all over the world, but she's also been seen in the theater. She's had her own more than one television series, and I'm not going to say it's merely because she's getting smart, because she's even more than that. You got to welcome the charming Miss Barbara Feldon. Folks. Barb, how you doing?
I couldn't be better, thank you. Thank you.
Sit down for us. Oh,
come on
up to the... You got to see the top. You know, I'm glad that they had you. I was kind of worried at first because I was groping, and then you said something to me just before, during the commercial about constantly working with one person.
What happens with her mind? Is there a brainwave pattern or something that you pick up? What is it?
I think what happened is, Barbara, and you know, I was worried, as I was saying to Monty Morgan, who working in, you know, in production has been so close to me. I was worried at first that people would think it was prearranged, but then, why should I worry about it? It was happening genuinely, and every time she sat down, I got another impression. What happened is, I think that she had made up her mind to concentrate so strongly, and I had literally zeroed in on her that it could have kept going. I got to tell you a story. I've never told this story. And you can imagine, Barbara, and I want to talk to you, not to myself, but an interesting incident. Once this happened in Rutgers University in New Brunswick, New Jersey, with a gal in the front row, was an audience of 3,000 people. Mm-hmm. She was so good. As she sat down, I said, "You were wondering if I could tell your boyfriend's name." She stood up. She sat down. I said, "By the way, when you came here tonight, you were talking about such and such." But at the end of the fourth or fifth time, she started to become slightly hysterical because... And I realized it was like when she sat and just let her mind wander, I was still with her, and it's kind of disarming.
Of course, it's almost like an intrusion in a way. Are you
unless
feel
a
so
person
vulnerable.
Wants it, and you're not vulnerable yeah. unless you concentrate. You, by the way, are just you're a fascinating. You know, I don't to say you are a highly intellectually thinking person. I can just tell, and people have told me this, and I mean that in a refreshing way. I'm kind of curious, Barbara, as you've traveled around, is there something in your lifestyle that intrigued you? Because I know you're searching. You're always interested in new things.
That happens to be true.
And that's not a reading. I know that about you.
No. The thing, I guess one of the things that interests me most is traveling, but not just traveling, physically traveling, but I mean traveling forward in life in terms of broadening out all of the time and experiencing new things and
with
being open to things.
And open to things.
Yeah, things and ideas. That's why I'm so fascinated with this. You know, that's what I was thinking too. By the way, you said you were worried that they would think that it had been prearranged. There's no way you would because yeah. I haven't seen you on this show before. I haven't been up here. And
you know,
it was so clear from watching
her reactions.
that it was not in any way planned.
Anything interesting about experiences you've had as you've traveled that seem unusual or strange?
Well, things happen. I find things happen in kind of in clusters to me. Coincidences
interesting.
Happen.
Coincidences.
I can think of one that has to do with a show that I used to do, Get Smart. On the show that I do, which you don't get up here, called Special Edition, which is more of a magazine format,
yes.
I traveled a great deal this year, and about 3 days before I left for Tahiti, Don Adams called me, who I co-starred with in Get Smart, and
we
he said, "I'm getting married on Saturday. Can you come to the wedding?" And I said, "Oh, I'm so sorry, but I'm going to be in Tahiti on the day that you're getting married." And he said, "Isn't that interesting? Because Dorothy, his ex-wife, was going to be on the same island in Tahiti as I was on that day in the South Pacific. So there was Dorothy, his ex-wife, and me, who played his wife on Get Smart,
that's
both
right.
on an island in the South Pacific together while he was getting married back in Los Angeles.
On the day you were going to be there.
Yeah, that's just one. I mean, it happens to me all the time.
Ever heard of anything called synchronicity?
I've heard of it. I can't spell it.
I have a devil of a time. It was created by a psychoanalyst by the name of Carl Jung.
Jung, yeah.
Who split with Freud because Jung became very mystical, and he theorized on something called the collective consciousness. He felt that there was information, without going into technical jargon because it's more mystical than science, he felt there was information that could be tapped by an area of our mind that was below the level of the conscious. And he felt there were paralleling experiences that may seem to have been separate in people's lives that somehow suddenly come together.
Mm-hmm.
Have you had anything else happen?
Oh, absolutely. A friend of mine is involved with a project that has to do with a circus.
Oh,
and
that's
exciting. First of all, he was involved with the project after he met me. I write poetry about circuses. It just happens to be something I like to do.
Next time I'd like you to bring some on. I really would.
Well, it's very personal poetry.
Right.
But in any case, I was then he got involved with this project with the circus, and he needed to find out how he could learn how to juggle. And I happened to be in the gym during this period, and there was a woman on one of these exercise things. And she said, she introduced herself and she said, listen, I have developed this whole circus training program. And just when he was looking for a person to teach him to juggle, she was sitting next to me and said, by the way, if you'd like to come and see what we teach over at the circus training program. I mean, how often does that happen to you in your life?
My.
Then we wanted to go to a museum where in a city outside of New York City where they have a circus museum. We didn't know where the museum was. We were at the theater the night before we were going to go to the museum. I saw sitting in the first row someone that I had gone to college with in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we're in Connecticut.
Where in
Connecticut.
Pittsburgh did you go to college?
Carnegie Tech. In
mm-hmm.
Carnegie
worked there many times.
Did you? And so I said, Leo, I mean, this guy, Leo Myers, I hadn't seen him since I was 22 years old.
Yes.
There's Leo. And I say to my friend, oh, you know, Leo might know where this circus museum is because he does props and things like that in the theater. So for the first time I've seen Leo in I'm not going to say
that
how many
years.
In that many years, I say to him, do you by any chance know where the blah, blah, blah museum, the circus
yes.
museum is in X City? And he said, I was just there today. He said, I'm working on a project that has to do with the circus, which was the same project that this guy was working on. And this all happened within 1 week.
Synchronicity. That's
yes.
kind of a reflection. We're going to be.
How do you explain it?
Well, no one has an explanation of that. I wish I could say, you know, right at our fingertips. I think it's more than coincidence, but I got to reflect in a simple way because the time has just run out. Why I was banned in Las Vegas, Nevada on April the 13th. We're going to have a little bit of fun after the following commercial break. And talk about synchronicity. The commercial just dropped in at this moment.
I hope it's about a circus.
I love the circus. We had a lot more time. Barbara and I talking about the circus, and circus has played a major role in my life because the people are fascinating. And you know what's interesting about them? We must realize if we talk to any kid, I'm opening the deck, and it's a brand new deck, Barbara.
I you can see that it is.
But you talk to any kid, they talk about dedication and study and hard work. The person in the circus has committed their life to their art, their skill,
mm-hmm.
whether it's working a tightrope or yeah. what have you.
Yeah, also, it means, the circus is something that I think means something to everyone. It might mean different things to
yes.
everyone, but it really gets inside our unconscious and becomes a symbolic thing in our lives, I think.
I think some psychologists should start studying the symbolicness of the circus,
of the circus.
More.
Yeah. Well, think of the clowns and the different aspects of that.
Barbara, you don't know what I'm going
to
do.
No,
and we're only
going to
have fun.
Out.
This is fun. I never knew the sadness when I was banned, and I'm not going to mention the casino that banned me from playing blackjack. And I play very little money. I'm not a gambler, but it's the way I unwind. I'm not going to mention the casino because I only played blackjack a couple of hours. And furthermore, I think that the MGM has had enough publicity as it is. But it is a true story, and it really happened. And, you know, I thought to myself, could it have been because of my work as a thought reader or because of my love of cards? Talk about my framework of the make-believe. This is a straight deck of playing cards. We don't have we do have a monitor. Maybe it can be brought closer, but it is a straight deck. Maybe I can see for a little while the monitor or get an idea of the position we're in from time to time. Barbara, you know what I'm going to do? And in a sense, I like to describe this as a kind of obsession. I don't usually use a monitor. I don't usually like to see one. But because I'm working with my hands, it'll give me an idea if I'm fanning cards properly and so forth. Barbara, name a card on the deck. Just name a card out loud.
Ace of Hearts.
I did not tell you to name that card.
No.
You were fascinated with my tuning on the thoughts of a young lady in the audience. I have not approached the deck since you named the card. There are 52 different cards. You name what card?
Ace of Hearts.
Turn the deck face up, Barbara. The whole deck face up. And there you are, folks.
That's
the very
incredible.
Card she named, the Ace of Hearts.
But you know what's incredible, too, is that I didn't expect to say that card. It's not a card that I would have said.
You kind of changed your mind
yeah,
as you were...
Yeah, I did.
Now,
I
Barbara,
started to say something else, and then I thought of saying...
Wasn't the king you were thinking of for a moment, no.
I'm not sure.
No. Now, Barbara, as... and I have... Well, as I'm going to hold the deck in my hand. Again, I don't know. I shuffle the cards up very much so. Barbara, as I deal cards on the table like this, one at a time, and they're falling, just call out stop anytime.
Stop.
Already.
Mm-hmm.
Before I turn over the card that's still remaining in my hand, what was the card you named before that you thought of apparently?
The Ace of Hearts.
Turn over the top card of the deck, Barbara.
That's
shuffle cards, Barbara. Shuffle cards. So you know.
Fantastic.
Yeah. You know, and I must tell you something. No sleight of hand. Sleight of hand could not have gotten you to thinking of a card which no one even on the staff knew, because I alone knew what was on the bottom. Now, I'm going to show you something. I'm telling you honestly, and I don't know which camera even to use for a close-up right now, but I don't know where that card is, that Ace of Hearts. The cards, let me shuffle them again, lest I've seen from a monitor. Barbara, I will level with you that you're going to say stop, and this time I will deal the cards onto the table face up like that. Mm-hmm. And deliberately face, and we can see them, because we've got a darn... Barbara, you, as I'm doing this, and I hope we can show the cards more. The camera is not showing Barbara and me that clearly. We've got the wrong angle, but that's all right, because we can't see the deck. I think we need a camera 3 or what have you. But anyway, Barbara, as I'm doing this, you call out stop anytime you want. You can wait as long as you want. Wait as long as you want. I don't care.
Stop.
Interesting. Because, folks, I know the exact amount of cards that we counted. You were not counting, were you, mentally?
No.
Look at where you stopped me, Barbara. The phenomena of this.
Yes.
So uncanny. Well, where we are in time, and it, as many of you know, because we cannot time the response of the mind, so I glance towards my floor man to just find out how much time we do have, and we don't really know right now, so I'm going to go on. What I want to do, folks, is this. Barbara, I'm going to rest the deck, and we will use the under table area in my hand so the cards fan out like that. You see how they will be. Mm-hmm. I can't spread them all out because of the fact that there's 52, so what I'll do is let me hold the deck under the table. Barbara, with your hand, reach under the table so you can find the cards. Just find them. Now, Barbara, move your hands back and forth. Put both hands under the table. Do not look at the card, but take, just with your right hand, take a card anywhere in the deck, anywhere. Just take it out, hold it in your hand. You can change it. Have you taken a card out
yet?
Keep it under the table. As a matter of fact, Barbara, take the rest of the deck in your other hand.
Okay.
In your other hand.
Okay.
Now keep the card on the table. The card you have, would you turn it face up and just stick it in the middle of the deck, under the table?
In the middle of the deck.
Stick it face up in the middle of the deck.
Oh.
You've turned it face up?
Wait a minute. I'm not sure which direction it's in now.
We'll just turn it over. Yeah,
turn
stick it,
it
in there. Under the table so you don't even know. That's fine.
I turn it over.
Yeah, and just put it in the deck.
I hope I did it right.
All right, stick it in the middle of the deck.
Okay.
Place the deck on top of the table.
Okay.
If you will, because it would be interesting if it happened.
Oh,
and look, folks.
Incredible.
Look what you chose. The beauty of it, folks, and I thank Barbara for being an excellent subject and so reflecting of what's been happening. But you know, the beauty of it is, folks, that you can see how an idea can become an obsession. An idea that encompasses us, if it's positive, can be so strong it can lead our life. It can be negative also. And frankly, there are times when an idea can be so powerful, it can almost haunt you. After all, folks, isn't that the dream of every commercial? I'll see you next week, be the good Lord willing. Goodbye, everybody.